Are you looking to make a website on one of the most powerful platforms on earth called WordPress? Then you must learn how to use the dashboard, and that's exactly what I'm going to explain to you throughout this video. So stay there. Hi there, this is John Lexa from ProSiteTutorials, where I talk about professional websites in 5 steps. So in this video, you are going to learn how to use a dashboard, which is really one of the parts of your website where you will pass most of your time creating your website. So it's really important for you to learn how you can use it well. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do is log in to your dashboard. For that, you go where you see your URL over here on the top section, and in front you just write this wp-admin. Once you have this extension, you just push the enter button and you can see the login page where you must have your username and also your password. This is the information that you should have received once you install WordPress to your email inbox. So just put the information over here and press login. If you want to, you may want to remember me so the next time you don't need to put your password once again. Okay, this is the first page that you will see, and quite honestly, this is not a page that later on you will use much, but once you are starting out, it might be quite useful, some of the functions that you see over here. If you want to customize your website, and by this I mean if you want to change the design of your website, you can click on this option, and this allows you to change the theme for your website. You can write your first post by clicking on this link. Add an about page where you talk about your website, about yourself, or if you have a team behind your website. You can also click on this option over here to view your website, just like this. You can manage widgets or menus. You can also turn on or off the comments on your website. And if you are starting out, this link over here might be quite useful because it provides some useful information for you. Jetpack is a plugin that I have installed on WordPress, which is quite good. And if you want to find more information about this plugin, just click on the link that you see on the screen. Quick draft is an option. Let's say that you wake up in the morning, you really have a great idea, but you are rushing to go to work. So what you do is you go over here and you write whatever you have in mind and just save it as a draft. That means it won't be published on the internet. And later on, once you arrive home, you go over there to your draft and see if it's really good for you to publish on your website. At a glance, you can see the number of posts that I have on my website, the number of comments, and also pages. Over here, you can see the theme that I'm using, and this is the design for my website, which is this one. As you can see, it's not anything great, but this one is called 2015. Over here you can see WordPress news, where they provide information about their latest updates, about bug fixes and stuff like that. Activity, you can see the posts that I have published on my website and also the comments that someone left on my website. Then you have the updates section. Anytime that you have something that you need to update, either a plugin or your theme needs an update, you will see a small number appearing over here on this section. Then you have Jetpack, which is the plugin. Then you have the post section, where you really will pass most of your time writing new content. You can go to all posts. This allows you to see all of the posts that you have in your website. You can see at this point, I have two posts that are safe as draft. That means that they aren't published on the internet. Then you can see, once I actually put my mouse on top of one of these titles, you can see some of new options appearing. You can do a preview so you can see how it looks like on the internet. Well, in this case, it's not an internet, it's still a draft, but that's how my post looks like. Then you have a trash if you want to remove this post from your website. Then you can use the quick edit if you want to quickly change some of the information belonging to this post. And then you have the edit, which allows you to alter the information in your post. If you want to add a new post, you just need to click on this small button that appears on the top section, or you can also click on this option that you see over here, and this automatically creates a new post where you can start writing new content for your website. Then you have the category section, and the category section is really useful later on once you have more posts, because it allows you to basically divide or separate your posts by topics. Let's say that you have a cooking website and you want to separate the meat dishes from the fish dishes, and then you can use the categories for that. Then you have tags. Quite honestly, you don't use this much nowadays, so it's not really relevant. Media is where all of the images in your website will appear. So each time that you had a new image, it will appear over here in this library. And then you have below the option to add a new image. Pages. Pages, the difference between pages and posts is pages is the static information that you want to add to your website. This can be either your contact page, your about page, and information that over the process of time, you really won't change much on your website. And the function is pretty much similar to the post. You add a new one over here or over here. Then you have the comments section, which allows you to see the comments that you have in your website. Over here, you can see all of the comments. You can see the ones that are pending. That means that you still need to review them before you publish them. Then you have the ones that are approved, the ones that were sent to spam, the ones that you actually removed will appear on your trash section. Over here under appearance, you can choose the theme that you want to use. As you can see, one of the fantastic features about WordPress is how easily you can change the whole design of your website. You can add a new theme over here by clicking on this option. And over here, you really have a vast selection of themes that you can choose for your website. You can go from the most popular ones. And let's just try a theme that I already have installed. So I'm going to activate this one. And once I refresh my website, you can see that it immediately changes the whole design for my website. Then you have customize. This allows you to alter your theme over here. It's a really good option. Widgets allows you to, basically widgets is this section that you see on the sidebar. And this allows you to either remove the widgets that you have already installed. Let's say that I want to remove this all and add a calendar and a recent post over here. Let's refresh my website. And you can see that this section changed. Now I have a small calendar and recent posts. Then you have the menu section. Menu section allows you to basically you can see the navigation bar that appears over here, but this navigation bar is automatically created by WordPress, and if you want to customize this, you need to create a new one. So you create a new one, let's say menu. Select where you want to appear, save, and let's say that I want to add this post to this section. Press save menus. See what this does, and you can see now the navigation bar change, and once someone clicks on this link, they are taken to this post where they can read it. This is just an example. Then you have the other section, and this really depends on the theme that you are using. It's really quite irrelevant at this point, and this options also. Then you have the plugin section, which allows it to see the plugins that you already have installed. At this point, I have AskyMed, which allows me to block comment spam, and this Hello Dolly, which doesn't do anything useful, and some other plugins, also the Jetpack one. You can also add a new one by clicking on this option over here below, and go over here and pretty much select whatever plugin that you want to add to your website. A plugin is basically an application that you can add to your website, which allows you to add some extra functions to your website. And this is really, I would say this is really one of the most powerful options when it comes to WordPress. Users allows you to see the users that you have in your website. Currently, it's only me, but you can add more people having access to your website using these options over here. Then you have tools, which allows you to basically allows you to, if you have a backup on your WordPress website, over here you can import that file and basically recover your website, or you can export that file and save it on your computer. Then you have settings. You can go from general, and this allows you to change your site title, which is this title that you see over here. And then you can also below change the tagline, which is this option that appears right below. And over here you can change the URL for your website if you don't want, if you want, for example, to have the three nice W's. You can do this just by doing this over here. And as you can see, now I have three W's appearing, but I must log in once again so I can go back to my website. And you can also change the date, the format, and other options using this feature that you see over here. Writing. You can select a default category for your posts. And you also have other informations over here. Then you have the reading section, which allows you to select how you want your front page to work. Has currently it's working has a blog. That means each time that I write a new post, it will appear on this section. But you can also select if you want, for example, a page to appear over here, a static page to appear over here. You can do this. You just choose the page that you want to appear as your front page. And once you do that, in this case, I need to go to my front page of my website, just like this. And you can see that I no longer have a blog section appearing. In discussion, you can change how you want your comments to work on your website. Then you have the media section, which allows you to customize the thumbnail sizes for your images, also the medium size and the large size for your images. And then you have the permalinks, which is the last option, which allows you to configure some of the options when it comes to your URL. So that is pretty much all about the dashboard and everything that you need to know about the dashboard so you can start using WordPress more successfully. That is all for this video. Please subscribe so you can receive my weekly video updates. That is all for now. Stay tuned with Pro Site Tutorials and bye. I